middle of November, Q4, everything's flying off the shelves, and I do have a minute though. I shipped out 65 orders yesterday, which is, that's all Monday sales, crazy. But what we're talking about now is the books that I bought at this point, 3 or 4 weeks ago, I guess. I think it was the last week in October. Anyways, what's happening with that, right? Because I bought, it ended up being about 3,000 books when it's all said and done. And I've sold, no clue on the number, but about $1,000 worth. And it's been a few weeks. So made $700 for a day's work. And then we're going to probably see another $2,000 or $3,000 trickle in over the next, year or two. But I do have some strategies I want to share with you about how I sold all these books so fast, because initially the idea of listing 3,000 books individually was, that was my idea, but it just became impossible. I didn't have the bandwidth for it. We talked about the inventory system, so these banker's boxes are all unorganized. That's a problem. What I'm doing sometime, who knows, it might be till January, 9 boxes per shelf, and we're gonna put a number somewhere on here, because right now they're all just not random but not organized. They go in there, and then what I found out quickly is that most of the books would sell a lot faster in sets. So here's one of the sets I have left over still. Catherine Cookson, a set of her books. Sold a whole bunch of vintage hardcovers that were probably worth less than $5 each in lots by color. There's one left. This is a green lot. I raised the price on the green lots because they sold out very fast. I've got some red lots over there. But for the most part, everything is in these boxes. So if I could find one right here, we'll just go over. Oh, well, it's heavy. So I'll open it up on the shelf, and then we can see like what's inside. So in 205, just books in there. That's a lot of Raggedy Ann books and some Bibles. Looks like nothing has sold out of 205, which is fine. For the most part, what I've sold were vintage kids' books lots. Those sold really fast. Lots of books prior to 1900. A lot of them 1800s with like gold leaf on them. It's called gilt-edged or gilded. This set right here sold for $129. It goes out today. It's well, it's, you can see right there, gold leaf book. I think it's Sir Walter Scott. No, it's not. But whatever, I don't want to, I'm not going to, absentmindedly shuffle through a book that I just sold. Anyways, whatever that is, the Sir Walter Scott lot sold for $129, international buyer, goes medium mail to Kentucky. Going forward, if I had to give you some advice about how to clean out houses and bulk books and everything, speed is your friend. List things that are going to sell as fast as possible, because inventory, at least in a case like that, it's not a problem. It's just there's so much of it. It's everywhere. Lots of books is really important. Hardcovers by color, by author, and then series of old kids' books. Like, for example, there were these American Girl history books. Sold a lot of those. Mandy was a book name, like Mandy and Friends, Mandy and the Specter of the Lighthouse. Old books like that.
The great thing, too, about books is it all goes out media mail. So for the most part, they're either going in boxes if there are lots of books, or poly mailers wrapped in a layer or two of bubble wrap. Actually, paper first, and then bubble wrap. I found that putting paper on books, people like that. I don't know why, like butcher's paper. The one acquisition I made for shipping supplies, I actually bought these to ship out vinyl records. You can't really tell, but those two boxes up there, one, two, are filled with vinyl records that I bought years ago, and I'm finally getting the listing. So I bought these, they're like 12-inch flats, cardboard flats. And I can actually put like oversized books in there, which has been extremely helpful. Like, for example, there's like this, if I sold this book right here, this is a book that I have to list. I haven't listed. It came from, I think I bought it to read personally, and I'm going to sell it now. I don't know. That will go in something like this, and it's just not going to have dinged up edges the way it would potentially have in a poly mailer with bubble wrap because it's bigger. And I just think that it kind of adds to the unboxing experience that a buyer has, because when they're spending a lot of money on these old books, personally, I believe that the unboxing experience is kind of important. Not like a huge thing, but if they're spending a bunch of money, like I said, and if I can wrap it in, what I've been using is this packing paper. I just wrap it in this packing paper. I bought it at Walmart. You get 200 of these sheets for $20 or less than that. It's like $10. And it ends up being good. I recently hit 5,000 sales on eBay since 2017. I think that account was opened up. But really, it's been 4,000 in the past 2 years. In 2020, I did 450 sales on eBay. This year, I'm going to do about 3,000, a little bit less than that. And it's been... And one of the things that I've learned, and across those 5,000 sales, zero negative feedback. So I feel like I'm doing something right. I feel good about this. I'm proud of the fact that I've been able to, I mean, watch now, I'll get somebody giving me bad feedback. But just 5,000 sales, most of those in the past 2 years, I feel like I've picked up a lot. And doing bulk buys like that only forces you to examine your systems and streamline things and make them more efficient. So going forward, what are we going to do? Well, we have to organize the boxes numerically. I'm still wasting time trying to find box numbers. It's a way better inventory system than just guessing, like I was, you know, trying to remember where things were previously, but it still leaves a lot to be desired. We're going to get all these shelves either full of packing equipment or boxes. Everything else is going to be listed or thrown away. There are a few things that are just like unsellable that I've had. Like old moldy books that I pulled out of there I couldn't sell. There's a lot of like broken toys that got returned from Amazon that just have to get thrown away. But streamlining the warehouse, getting everything off the floor, and making it so when I want to get out of here, I don't have to remember where things are. All I have to do is move boxes. Because if, you know, you can pay someone to move boxes, I can find somebody and pay them a couple $100 over a weekend, and they will move all my boxes from point A to point B, from here to a building I build on my property, for example. That's where we're at. That's what I've learned from this huge buyout. I'm still looking for more buyout, but everyone says, yeah, I'll get back to you next year. You know, they put out these Facebook ads, and then I respond, and they say, yeah, well, I'm busy until Christmas. And I say, okay, well, I'll be here in the winter. And that gives me an advantage, because most people are not willing to do the work in the winter when it's cold up here in Michigan. That's I was listening to a football game, and the coach was talking about what his coach said to him, and he said the person who wins, the team who wins, is who goes the hardest, the longest. And I think that's true. If I can go harder and longer than everyone else trying to get free books, you know, clean out stuff, whatever it is in my area, then I'm gonna succeed, because I have the system down where I can just put inventory in. I know how to price stuff. I know how to ship stuff. Everything's coming together, and now it's a matter of just like willpower and sticking to it. So I hope you guys are with me on this, because I'm ready to go. I'm ready to hit the next, you know, 10,000 eBay sales. On a side note, am I doing Amazon still? Barely. Very few things. There's just so many issues with Amazon. We can go into that in a later video. But for now, I feel really good about eBay. And the prospects that organizing my inventory in a way that I can move it around leads to. Hey, if you're new, if you watched this your first video, please subscribe. If you're not new, thanks for sticking around all these years. My business is growing, it's changing, and I'm glad to have you along for the ride. Give it a thumbs up and comment with, I don't know, anything you want to say. Something about Christmas, something about Thanksgiving. How's the weather where you are? See you guys later.